We're going to take a look at the circular flow diagram. This is a really handy model to use in economics. It's just a very fundamental concept that just shows how what goes around comes around in the economy. So we're going to start off here with households. Households provide labor and other resources that are used in the production of goods and services, all those goods and services that we're measuring in GDP. Businesses are over here. Businesses are producing all those products and providing all those services, all those things that are measured in the GDP. And you can kind of think about people from these households. That would be labor, one of the resources that are used in the economy. Labor is leaving their houses, going to work at businesses. And then the businesses are taking those resources, labor and other resources, and converting those to products and services. And so here go the products and services back to the households where they're consumed. So this is, so far we've got resources that are flowing from the households to businesses. Businesses are converting those resources into products and services, which then are going to the households where they're consumed. Down here we have a, we're going to just call this a factor market. This is the market for resources and other factors of production. Okay, so this is the factor market, and this is where wages are determined, prices of other resources are determined in this factor market. And then up here we have the product market, and of course it's short for product and services, so it's products and services. But it's the product market. This is where the prices of goods and services are determined. You can kind of think of just lots of Walmarts everywhere. That's a good example of a product market. Prices are determined in the product market. All right, so far so good. Now, what happens when these people from households go to work in the businesses? What happens at the end of the week or the end of the month? We have something flowing in the other direction. What is that? It's a paycheck. All right, so money is flowing in this direction. Businesses are paying households for their resources. Households are then taking that money and going out and spending it at Walmart and other places. And so that money then is flowing back to businesses. Now, this is a really simple model because in real life, and when you take other economics courses, microeconomics, for example, you'll get into some of the ways that households, some of the reasons that households don't necessarily spend every last penny. They spend some of that money to pay taxes. Some of that money goes into savings. Okay, but we're going to keep it really simple here for our purposes for this course. And we're going to say that every dollar that comes into the household goes out in a form of spending for goods and services. And so we have money flowing in a counterclockwise direction here, paying for the goods and services that are flowing in the clockwise direction. And so this is a closed system, so the value of the money going around is equal to the value of the products and the services and the resources that are being used. And so this model is one way to show how, if you're calculating the GDP, you should come up with the same figure whether you're using the income approach or whether you're using the expenditure approach. In the textbook, we're focusing on expenditures. But the author does talk a little bit about how income is equal to expenditures in a very simple sense. So hopefully this explained a few things about the circular flow diagram.